Welcome to this class of General Microbiology with the subject code BT252 offered to third semester of second year. So today we are going to look into one important aspect of microbiology without which the study of microorganisms is not possible, and that aspect is about the media of culturing of microorganisms. The topic of the presentation is types of microbial culturing media. Now, to understand this topic better, we need to understand what is microbiology, what is microbiological nutrition media, and what are their types. So microbiology, if you look into the definition of the microbiology, you will find that there is the definition, it lies in its term itself, that is microbiology, which is the study of microorganisms, which is again, if you want to define microorganisms, these are the organisms which cannot be seen by naked eyes, and therefore it requires the highly specialized instrumentation, that is the microscope, for its study. So in a proper precise manner, if you want to define microbiology, it becomes the study of great variety of living organisms that are too small for us to see without microscope, and these microscopic organisms, these are called as either microbes or the microorganisms. Now when you want to study them in the laboratory, there is an essential requirement of growing them in the laboratory. And for growing them in the laboratory, there is a requirement of a nutritional medium in which it can grow. So the nutritional medium composition, it would require all those nutrients which would be supporting the growth of the microorganism. And for the growth of a microorganism, different type of microorganisms may have different types of nutritional requirement. And the basic content or the basic component of the nutritional media is the water, which would be consisting of further some substances that would support the growth of the microorganism, and that would provide the energy to the microbial cells. So overall, this should be the basic composition of a nutrient medium, that it should be consisting of water, and then it should consist of all those substances which would support the growth, and that would provide the energy to the cell. Okay, and this whole composition would be then termed as a nutritional medium. Different microorganisms, they have different such nutritional requirements, and such media that contains these substances, that is the nutrients which are required for the growth of microorganisms, becomes the nutritional media for microorganisms. Now, based upon the different requirements of different types of microorganisms, then based upon the composition of the medium, based upon their physical states of the medium, this media, they have been classified into different types. So in general, the media can be liquid media or a gel media, which also we can call it as a solidified medium, which are used for growth and identification of the microorganisms. And based upon their physical state, you can see here that there are two major types of this nutritional medium, which is one liquid medium, another one is the solid medium. Now liquid medium, it is also called as broth medium, whereas solid medium, it is also known as agar medium. So whenever you will have a term broth in association with the medium name, it will be considered as a liquid medium, and whenever you will have a term agar associated with the name of the media, it will be a solid medium. Based upon the composition of the medium, there are two major types of media. One is the complex medium, another is the synthetic medium. Complex medium, also known as chemically undefined medium, whereas synthetic media, it is known as chemically defined media. Now this two types, they are based upon the composition. What are the components? Upon that, this media, they have been classified, and based upon the application or function of the media, there is a list of media which are known as cultivation media or enrichment media, selective media, differential media, storage media, assay media, maintenance media, likewise. So now next what we'll do is we'll look into what are the properties and what is the example of all this media. So first of all, let us look into the liquid growth medium. Liquid growth medium, of course, it is a liquid media, and the basic essential component of any media is water. So the nutrients, they are dissolved in water, and this in this media, since it is in the broth form or it is in the liquid form, when the microorganisms, they are grown in this media, it grows in a suspension. So whenever there is a requirement of a suspension culture, liquid media, they are used. Now this media, these are also important industrially, wherein there is requirement of production of some certain industrially important compounds, like maybe citric acid or maybe ethanol. Then such production processes can be enhanced with the use of the liquid medium. The example of this liquid medium is a nutrient growth medium. Then next is the solid growth medium. This solid growth medium, it is usually used for the isolation and for getting the pure cultures of the microorganisms. This media, it is prepared by dissolving the nutrients in water and then solidifying it with the gelling agent as agar-agar. Agar-agar, it is a gelling agent which is added to the nutrient medium. It is boiled and then allowed to set to form a gel. So this acts as a gelling medium or a solidifying medium. Then this solid media, they can be used for cultivation of many different types of microorganisms. It is used for isolation of pure cultures and also used to accomplish the tasks such as the media that can be used for measuring the population growth, like number of cells of microorganisms per unit of the sample, which may be per gram of soil or per ml of milk or per ml of any wastewater. So there are different tasks that can be achieved with the solid growth medium. This solid growth medium, it is also used for characterization of microorganisms. The best example that can be cited here for solid growth medium would be nutrient agar. Nutrient agar, which is very frequently used medium in the teaching laboratories for cultivation and maintenance of the bacteria. Let us look into some of the properties of agar-agar. Some important properties. Since agar-agar, it is used as a solidifying agent in microbiology, and it has got certain significant properties because of which it has got so much of importance in microbiology. And it is that the first one is from where it has been isolated or where it is found. It is found in the marine red algae, and this polysaccharide, it is extracted from that red algae. It is not a nutritional component in the media. The role of this agar-agar in the media is only for solidifying purpose. It does not serve as a source of nutrient. The melting point of agar-agar is above 85 degrees to 95 degrees, and the gelling temperature is 32 degrees to 45 degrees Celsius. So when the media, when agar-agar is boiled above 96 degrees, it starts melting or it melts completely, and when the whole melted agar solution down when it comes to a temperature of 45, so below that 45 degree it starts solidifying, which is one of the very important property to be property of agar agar to be used as a solidifying agent in microbiology. In a composition of any nutrient media, which is a solid media, the concentration of agar agar to make it solidified is very important, and the concentration of agar agar in the medium, it can be anywhere between 1.5 to 2%. So 1.5% also can give a good solidified medium. Next, based upon the composition of the nutritional medium, there are two major types of the growth medium, that is the complex medium and the synthetic medium. Now, complex media, it is known as complex media or also as chemically undefined media, because here the exact composition of the medium, it is not known. Whereas in case of synthetic medium or chemically defined medium, the exact composition of the medium, it is known. Now, what is mean by exact composition of the medium is not known? You can understand better it from the next chart, that is, this is an example for complex agar medium and this is the composition of a synthetic broth medium. Now, what you can find here is, in complex agar medium, there is pectone, beef extract, sodium chloride and agar and water. So, pectone, it is a digest of a proteinaceous material, and that digested material, it contains amino acids and peptides. Okay, beef extract, it is the extract in which there is presence of vitamin, there is presence of minerals and certain other nutrients. Now, these two components, where we know that pectone, it will contain, it is a digested form of protein and so it contains amino acids and peptides. But exactly how much amount of amino acid or exactly which amino acids are present, it is not known. Okay. Whereas in beef extract, the amount of vitamins, the amount of minerals, which vitamins, which minerals, that information is unknown. So, therefore, it is said that the exact composition of the media is not known, and therefore, it is called as complex agar medium or chemically undefined medium. Whereas, if you look into the composition of synthetic broth medium, you will find here glucose, ammonium phosphate, sodium chloride, magnesium sulfate, potassium sulfate and water. Now here, for each of the component, we know exactly how much amount of that compound is present in the medium, plus we also exactly know the components. So that is why synthetic broth medium, it is also known as chemically defined medium. Now, usually from the example, what you can find that the media, usually they would contain the digest, maybe from animals or maybe from the plants or the microorganisms. And this media, complex media, they are usually used in the laboratory for the maintenance of the microbial culture. In case of synthetic media, since we know the precise chemical composition of the medium, this media, they are used when you want to know the exact requirement of the microorganism, then that case synthetic medium they are being used. The example of synthetic media is Zabbix-Cox medium. In this category of nutritional medium, types of microbial nutritional medium, the next category is a function-based growth media. Now, function-based growth media, they have certain characteristic features that using this function-based growth medium, you can determine some particular characteristics of the microorganism. That means this can be used for a specific function, for a specific reason. So, the characterization of the microorganisms can be very well performed by using the specific required function-based growth medium. The first category of that media is the cultivation media. Now, for cultivation of microorganisms, there is requirement of certain medium composition which can be used for its cultivation or for its growth. Okay, so the media which is used for general cultivation purpose of bacteria or microorganisms, they are called as the cultivation media, and the general purpose media are nutrient broth and nutrient agar. Next is the enrichment media or enriched media. The term here itself, it shows that there is something which is enriching the growth of microorganism or some substance which would help in allowing the growth of a particular specific type of microorganism. So the media, it is enriched with a specific type of medium or a specific type of nutrient. So this medium in which nutritional environment, it is adjusted in such a manner that it will enhance selectively the growth of one type of population and would not support the growth of another type of population of the microorganism. So when a mixed population will be grown in such type of media, the media, it will support the growth of that particular type of microorganisms or bacteria only. Okay. Now, here what is that which is used to enrich the medium? So there might be certain properties of microorganisms, like the microorganisms may be producing a specific category of enzymes, let us say maybe cellulase, and in that case the composition of the medium, it can be made in such a way that it can be added with cellulose as a carbon source, as the only carbon source. So cellulose will be utilized by only those microorganisms which can produce cellulase. So therefore the cellulose containing medium would support the growth of only those type of microorganisms which would produce cellulase. This cellulase will act upon the cellulose, it will hydrolyze the cellulose, and the end products, the simple sugars that will be formed, will be taken up as a source of carbon, source of energy. So in that case, cellulose will be the component which is enriching the medium. Then there are certain fastidious microorganisms which also requires the enriched medium, where the media can be enriched with certain special components like blood. So if the media contains blood, only those microorganisms which can utilize blood as a source of energy or source of nutrient, those microorganisms would grow in that medium. So here this fastidious heterotrophic bacteria that can be isolated by use of this enriched medium. Selective media. The name itself shows that it is selecting the particular group of microorganisms to grow in that medium. So if you have certain microorganisms where it has a very special different characteristic from some other major group of microorganisms, then such media can be designed based upon the property, special property of the microorganisms, and then it can be used only for isolation of a specific that particular microorganism. The media composition, it is designed in a way that the composition, the components, some of the components in the medium would inhibit the growth of unwanted microorganism and would support the growth of only required microorganism. So when you will inoculate a mixture of microorganisms into the selective media, it will inhibit all other microorganisms. It will not allow to grow any of the other microorganism, unrequired microorganism, and it will only support or allow to grow only the required microorganism. The basic growth medium in this case, it is added with maybe some extra salt, because higher salt concentration, it inhibits the growth of majority of the microorganism, and there are some microorganisms which can tolerate higher concentration of the salts. So for those microorganisms which can tolerate higher salt concentration can be grown in such selective medium, or it can be added with a dye wherein the dyes can inhibit the growth and thereby allowing only those microorganisms to grow which can tolerate this dye or don't get inhibited by the presence of the dye. The example is a mannitol salt agar for staphylococci. This mannitol salt agar, it contains the vannitol, which is a source of carbon and energy, and it contains a higher salt concentration. Higher salt concentration, it inhibits the growth of most of the microorganism. Mannitol supports the growth of only those microorganisms which can utilize this sugar and utilize it for its energy and for its growth and development. So this media, where you can see the media is pink, initially or originally the media is pink, and when the culture is grown on this medium, this you will find there is a zone, yellow zone, which is formed. This is because of utilization of the mannitol by the microorganism, and after utilization of this mannitol, there is production of acid. So there is a fermentation of mannitol by the microorganism. So here in this media, you can find it. From this figure, you can find it out that the organisms or the bacteria which utilizes mannitol as a source of energy, it is only growing. Moreover, there is a distinguishing color, that is yellow color, which is formed because of the production of acid, that is the change in the pH. This media, it supports the growth of staphylococci. Staphylococci, it can utilize mannitol as a source of energy, as a carbon source, and it also ferments mannitol to produce acids, and it tolerates a higher salt concentration. Next category is a differential medium. Now differential medium, it is a medium which is used for differentiation of two different types of microorganisms. So there you can design the medium based upon some differential characteristic, like fermentation of any substrate into acid or no acid. So there can be microorganism which can utilize the substrate or a sugar, but some of them the population of microorganism can produce acid, whereas some other population may not produce acid. So to differentiate between such two groups of microorganisms, the media that will give the distinctive property in the same media could be called as a differential medium. So this media, it is employed to determine the differential reactions which may permit presumptive identification of bacterial species. Okay, and this, the basic growth component, to make it differential medium, the basic growth component, basic growth medium, it is added with the compound which can differentiate their specific biochemical or biophysical properties. The media can be composed with specific chemicals to indicate which species possess and which lag a particular biochemical process. Now such indicators may be the pH indicators. Such indicators may be based upon some addition of some new biochemical agent into the medium. So the example is the blood agar. You can take blood agar medium. This blood agar medium, when the microbial population is grown on this blood agar medium, you can distinguish two different types of the microorganisms, hemolytic and non-hemolytic. Hemolytic means blood agar will contain blood. Now this blood, it contains RBCs. So hemolytic as in that the microorganisms which can lyse the RBCs, and non-hemolytic the microorganisms which cannot lyse the RBCs. So in the medium, if there is a hemolytic microorganism present, what will happen is surrounding the growth of the microorganism, there will be a clear zone which will be formed. That clear zone will be because of the lysis of the RBC, whereas non-hemolytic bacteria would produce no clear zone because these bacteria, they are not able to lyse the RBCs, and therefore no RBCs will be lysed in the surrounding zone, and therefore no clear zone will be observed in that case. So based upon the clear zone formed and the no clear zone formed, the bacteria can be distinguished or differentiated as hemolytic and non-hemolytic, and the media which is supporting such type of differentiation is blood agar medium. So blood agar medium becomes the differential medium. There is another example of differential medium, which is Meconkey agar. Now Meconkey agar, it contains a lactose sugar, and it can differentiate between the two categories of bacteria, lactose fermenter and the non-lactose fermenter. If the lactose is fermented, then there is a production of acid which would turn the color of the pH indicator to pinkish, and if there is no lactose fermentation, then there will be no color change. This media, it contains the pH indicator. So if there is an acidic pH, the color changes to pink, and if there is no acid formation, then there is no change in the color. So this media, it can differentiate between the lactose fermenters and the non-lactose fermenters. Examples of this bacteria, it is also given here that E. coli and Klebsiella species, these are the lactose fermenters, whereas Pseudomonas and Salmonella, these are the non-lactose fermenter. Similar type of differentiation you can also find it in the selective medium, that is the mannitol salt agar, which the mannitol salt agar, it is selective because it contains higher concentration of the salt, but it is along with selective, it is also a differential medium because it can differentiate between the two types of bacteria or two types of microorganisms which can tolerate a higher salt concentration, but differentiated based upon the fermentation pattern of mannitol, whether the fermentation end product is acid or not. So if the fermentation end product is acid, then it will show a yellow color. If the fermentation end product is not acid, so then in that case the color, no color change will be observed. So mannitol salt agar becomes an example of selective as well as differential medium. About these three different function-based nutritional media, that is selective media, differential media and the enriched media, we'll see some of the characteristics. The components, it contains growth stimulators and growth inhibitors. Growth inhibitors for unwanted, growth stimulator for wanted or required microorganism. Differential medium, it contains dyes for differentiation purpose. It contains growth stimulants and growth inhibitors, and enriched media, it will contain the growth stimulators or growth stimulants. Like the example we have seen is a blood agar, so blood would be the growth stimulant for a particular organism, or cellulose. Utilization of this type of media is selecting certain microorganisms out of a mixture of population. Differential medium, distinguishing different types of microorganisms in a mixture, and enriched medium, cultivating the fastidious microorganisms. Examples: mannitol salt agar for selective medium, meconki agar for gram-negative bacteria differential medium, and blood agar for streptococci, chocolate agar for Neisseria species are the examples of the enriched medium. In the category of function-based nutrient medium, you have another categories of or examples or types of nutritional media, that is the storage media, assay media and maintenance media. Storage media, of course, it is used for storage purpose. So if you want to store the particular type of pure culture of microorganisms, then in that case these stock cultures, they can be maintained for a longer period of time on the medium, and then that media, since it is used for storage purpose, it is known as the storage medium, like the yeast extract mannitol agar medium. Assay media, some microorganisms can be assayed on the medium itself. Assayed as in they are analyzed or they are tested for the specific properties, like maybe for production of enzyme or maybe for production of certain particular compound. Okay, so for determining the presence or absence of such enzymes, or for production of enzymes, or determining the production of certain specific compounds, in that case the media, it is incorporated with the substrates or some special components on which, when the microorganisms, they are being grown, if that microorganism possesses the particular specific property, then there would be certain distinctive changes that would occur on the medium, which can show the presence or absence of a property. Just like the blood agar, hemolysis and non-hemolysis, a clear zone is formed surrounding the hemolytic bacteria. So similarly, in case of starch medium, this starch media, they are being used for assay of the microorganisms that can produce amylase. So when a pure culture of the amylase producing microorganism will be inoculated and cultured on the starch medium, starch will be hydrolyzed by the amylase which is produced by the microorganism, and there will be zone of hydrolysis production surrounding the growth of the microorganism. So this is one of the example of the assay medium. And then you have a maintenance medium. Maintenance media, these are the media which are used for storage or maintenance of the microorganisms, wherein there is particular term maintenance, which means maintenance of the physicochemical properties and viability of the cell. It is being maintained, because over a period of time, if the microorganisms, they are not supported by the proper nutritional medium, there might be alterations in the microbial characteristics that may occur, and that there might be loss of viability. So it is very important in microbiology to maintain the cultures over a period of time, for a longer period of time, and to maintain those cultures in its viable form and without affecting its physiological characteristics, there is a requirement of a maintenance media. Now in general purpose laboratory, maintenance media can be nutrient agar also. The composition of such maintenance media is very important, and this composition, it should support, not only support the growth of the microorganism, but it should not also lead to production of certain end products which would be toxic to the growth of the microorganism. So the composition is very important in case of maintenance media, so that the media should keep the microorganisms in the viable form and the not altering the physiological characteristics of the microorganisms. So what we have seen today is all about the different types of different types of nutritional media which are used for different purposes in the microbiology. Thank you.